destroyed on sight.
When there is no more room in hell.
Heavy Metal. A trip beyond the future to a universe you've never seen.
Phantasm. Is it a fantasy?
Mr. West.
You'll never get credit for my discovery. Who's going to believe a talking head? Get a job in a sideshow.
Did you hear that?
I heard that.
What was it?
Hey guys, Happywaxs here from Doomgorium's Horror Emporium, and I am starting a new segment called Happywaxs Video Vault. And what that is going to consist of is stuff that I enjoy in my day-to-day goings-on in 40 years plus on this planet Earth, whether it be horror movies, science fiction, stuff that I go to, whether it be expos or horror conventions or anything, even my trip down to the comic book store with my daughter. I want to show you that stuff because I do see quite a bit, as well as I want to show you stuff that I find on the internet, whether it be music I enjoy, or awesome clips of movies that are coming out soon, or movies that are been out for 30 years. I have a really large selection of VHS tapes that I want to show with you, or share with you, sorry. I'm pretty sure that a large majority of you don't even recognize what this is. This is a VHS tape, okay, and this is Dawn of the Dead. Okay, on VHS. So, I have 3,000 of these tapes, or close to it, and I am going to show and review some of this old stuff, as well as talk about some new stuff, some music, and I will show you my collection of horror paraphernalia, whether it be t-shirts, posters, face casts, action figures, all that sort of stuff. So, hope you enjoy it. As the show gets rolling, please leave a comment. And let me know if there's something you want me to talk about, or a movie that you're unsure of, whether you should see it. I'll let you know. That's what I'm here for. So, anyways, let's get the show rolling.
Stuff I have lying around my house.
Okay, so the first thing I want to show you out of my collection on this week's show is my miniature cast of Vincent Price's face. Now, to the best of my knowledge, I was told when I bought it, when I purchased it, that only two people on the planet own this. Me being one of them, and Vincent Price's daughter actually being the other one. Now, the artist who made it is my friend Anthony, who works at True Love Tattoo in London, Ontario, who does a spectacular job. And he cast two of these. He did this one, which I now own, and he gave one to Vincent Price's daughter at the Fan Expo, which was just this past year. So, yeah, so this is the first thing I want to show you out of my collectibles. I've got a ton more, but we'll start off with this one. And for any of you who want to check it out a little bit better, I will be putting a picture of this up on my Facebook page. And if you want to join me on Facebook, just go to Happywaxs. That's all you have to type in, just Happywaxs, H-A-P-P-Y-W-A-X. And add me as a friend, and I'll have a picture of this up later on today. And you can check it out. It's quite detailed, and I'm sure you will enjoy it. And I'm probably sure you wish you had one.
Trailer time.
Okay, it's trailer time, and today I'm going to show you a movie that I am just stoked about seeing, Prometheus. If you've been on the internet in the last month or so, there's two movies that everybody seems to be talking about. Batman, which I'm going to do on another show, and Prometheus. This movie looks fantastic. I'll tell you right now, this better not be one of those movies where you watch the trailer and it's like, whoa, you know what I mean? And then you go see it in the theater and you're like, ugh. You know, so I got my fingers crossed. Hopefully it's good. I mean, Ridley Scott's doing it. He did the original Aliens. He did Gladiator, Blade Runner, Black Hawk Down. So, I mean, it's got that going for him. The guy's a genius. And, you know, the trailer alone gives you goosebumps. So I can't see it being bad. So I'm going to show it, and I'm not going to talk about it after. It's just a trailer. So, but I have one quick thing, though. I have seen some stuff on the internet about people saying it's not a prequel. It's more of a spin-off. Well, I disagree. For those of us who are diehard fans of the series, if you look in the trailer, you can actually see set pieces that were used in the original Alien. So just check it out. Let me know what you think. It's in high def. So, I mean, you see everything, and it just looks fantastic. So sit back and enjoy.
Thank you. king has his reign. And then he dies. It's inevitable.
Prometheus is dead.
These are ancient civilizations that were separated by centuries, and yet, this same pictogram was discovered in every one of them.
They're smiling.
I think they want us to come and find them.
We're all here because of a map you two kids found in a cave.
Not a map. An invitation.
From whom?
Please tell me you can read that.
Prometheus, are you seeing this?
Whatever that probe is picking up, it's reading life form.
What do you mean a life form?
Oh, the head.
They're changing.
Changing into what?
It's moving. These things moving.
What is that?
There's a ship.
They're leaving.
To go where?
Earth.
We were so wrong.
Take us home! If you don't stop it, there won't be any home to go back to.
Very amateurish attempt on my person. Being a genius certainly has its advantages.
People I've squished are bloated up this week.
Get all this and then tell Todd how many you've all got.
Yeah, here's a raise for you.
Old school VHS, baby.
Okay, guys, it's VHS time, and today I'm showing Dawn of the Dead. Let's check the trailer out, and then I'll come back and we'll have a little chit chat.
1968, George Romero brought us Night of the Living Dead. It became the classic horror film of its time. Now, George Romero brings us the most intensely shocking motion picture experience for all times. Dawn of the Dead. Night of the Living Dead has ended. Dawn of the Dead is here.
Get that room!
Gets up and kills. The people it kills get up and kill.
They must be destroyed on sight.
When there is no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth. Dawn of the Dead.
Okay, so for those of you who don't know what this is my VHS copy of the director's cut of the original Dawn of the Dead. This movie is fantastic in any format that you see it, and I will just give you a quick history of the goings-on of Dawn of the Dead and some confusion about whether this is a zombie. So what happened was, and I'll be brief, is Dario Argento and Giorgio Romero made this movie. Romero was the director. Argento was one of the producers along with Romero, and one of their deals was is that Argento did the European version, so he edited it, and it was a non-English speaking film shown all over Europe, and then Romero was responsible for anything over here, Canada, US, surrounding area. So there's a couple different versions, which you can get on DVD. This is the American version, the theatrical version. There's some footage in here that's not in the European version, and there's some footage in the European version that's not in this version. And then also some other confusion about the name. In Europe, this was called Zombie. It wasn't called Dawn of the Dead. And what happened there was for Fulci's movie that came out in 79, this movie did so well in Italy in 78 that he kind of wanted to jump on the back of the movie. So he called his movie Zombie 2. So that's where that title came from for that movie. So, but this one was called Dawn of the Dead over here, and it was called Zombie over in Europe when it first came out. And then Fulci hopped on board and called his movie Zombie 2, hoping to get some good kickback and make lots of money off the coattails of this movie. So that's kind of how that happened. And for all of you who have been living under a rock for the last 30 plus years, you got to check this movie out if you haven't seen it already. I doubt you'll get it on VHS, but there's Blu-ray copies, DVD copies all over the place. I've yet to see it on TV, but who knows, just go buy a copy. So anyways, there it is, VHS copy, Dawn of the Dead, one of my favorites. If you have any comments or if you have any suggestions of old movies that you want me to show a copy of, please feel free to comment and let me know what you think. I've got thousands of these, which I'll be showing you on a weekly basis. So let me know what you think, and I will talk to you later.
How about some hot chocolate, huh?
Okay, guys, that wraps up this show. I usually show stuff I have laying around my house, collectibles and stuff, for old relics and stuff. But here, I thought I'd end the show, and I wanted to show you my two dogs, which are, in fact, two old relics. This is Bailey. She is 16 years old. And this is Baxter, and he's 17 years old. So do the math, times it by 7, and these are pretty old dogs. So anyways, hope you enjoyed the show. Like I said, leave a comment and any suggestions of stuff you want me to talk about in future episodes, or people you may want me to blow up. But if you got any suggestions, let me know. Hope you liked it, and we'll see you soon.
Did you guys like that?
Yeah.